Welcome to the wrap-up of week Urban Food and Green Space. In this video, I will reflect with Jan-Willem van der Schans and Jotte de Koning on the different forms of co-creation we have seen this week on urban food and green space. So, Jan-Willem, to start with you, could you please share with us what has been most notable to you in the in the different forms of co-creation and to achieve actually urban sustainable food systems?
Yeah, what I think struck me most is that food systems are part of a more complex urban system or several urban systems. Food is related to real estate development. We also have employment issues. We have climate mitigation issues and green space management issues, public health issues. So I think the food system is part of a much more complex urban system, and we have to deal with that. And we saw examples in the last week how citizens were dealing with this.
Yeah, this indeed seems like a very complex issue. So Jotte, could you please take this to the context of Hanoi and share with us what did we see there? What does this mean in that context?
Yeah, well, we saw in Vietnam, in Hanoi specifically, that the consumers there, they're changing their life patterns because of a changing economy. It's emerging, and therefore the preferences are changing. And then food safety is a big driver of these changes. And this complex system now, people are, with their daily routines, are trying to co-create a new system that fits their new practices. And also what you see is that forms of activism and grassroots are emerging to also change the food system there.
Yeah, so that sounds quite interesting. So they are really active in this food system, but then it's confined within this high density of a built structure of a city. So how do we need to see this? Could you please elaborate on that a bit?
I think we have also seen that in a city there are open spaces where you can have certain forms of citizen engagement, but you have also buildings, in and around buildings. And there the forms of citizen engagement are quite different because you have an owner of a building and you need access to the building to work with. And also what we see is that inside buildings, the systems of food production are quite high tech, so you need a lot of education to actually co-create in this way of food production. And on the other end, in the open space, you can still do low-tech growing of food where you can engage citizens, the community, your children, and all that. So the forms of co-creation are quite different there.
Yeah, so I see. So you have a bit open space, low-tech, and indoor high-tech maybe, this kind of difference. But then the roles of the citizens involved with those systems must be quite different because it's already on the knowledge. Could you share something about the different roles of citizens in those co-creation processes with us, Jotte?
Yeah, well, also again in Vietnam we saw these different roles already emerging. You saw people become co-producers of the food system by also taking action, producing food themselves, but also being involved in certain local operations. And you see that by also taking these new roles, becoming co-producer, they transform themselves from not only being citizen or consumer towards really co-creators of the system.
So this week we have seen the various ways in which citizens engage with urban food and green space. So could you highlight for us the aspects that illustrate how these co-creation processes work out in different contexts? So Jotte, for example, in Hanoi, could you highlight some important aspects of this co-creation process with citizens?
Yeah, well, in Vietnam, in Hanoi, we saw that these local small and medium enterprises, SMEs, they work together in an active process with citizens, their consumers. And this was a guided process. And it was adapted to the context and really the cultural values of Vietnam, so it fitted these interactions. And also what we saw that this process was actually resulting in sort of a building of a community around these local SMEs, as well as some small changes in the product. Unfortunately, not radical changes, but still there were incremental food adjustments there.
Okay, that's interesting. So, and how did it work? What are some aspects from the Netherlands, from a different context, that you could share with us?
Okay, I think one thing is interesting to mention is that that SMEs can play a role also, normally in the literature we find a caricature that we have the market, public, the government, and we have civic action, but here we actually see a hybrid process. I think that's quite interesting. And if we then go to the Netherlands, to the Duck Park example, I think what we can learn there, that really to have lasting impact, citizen engagement really needs to organize itself, because otherwise it will probably play a role in the design stage, but not in the real management of the green space that is created through the design. I think that's quite important that we go for processes of institutionalization as well. And that means that actually we need top-down approaches and bottom-up approaches, and we need to meld them together in order to make a lasting impact on the urban food system.
Yeah, exactly. So we also need these structures to organize these co-creation processes. So both from bottom up and top down, that these structures also meet and work so. Both ways, so that they both can, in the end, influence the regime or how things are done now.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
So basically, it's top down, bottom up structuration for sustaining these co-creation processes in the longer run.
Yeah.
So what we actually see is that the food system is already changing, that's what we have encountered thus far. But when we look ahead, what would it mean? What would you suggest? How could, for example, public authorities or private companies or civil society organizations advance this development towards a more urban, sustainable food and green space system? And what type of co-creation would be best suited to to facilitate this transition, in fact? Maybe to start with you. Go ahead.
Yes. Well, you see actually two different types of ways of doing this. One is that the regime, how things are now, that their people within can start changing, start adapting, start changing the way things are done, and then inviting others to co-create these changes. On the other hand, you also see that more bottom-up and grassroots are also like providing alternatives. So they're really outside of what's done. They're providing their alternative systems to the food. And there's different types of co-creation, because they, within their own group, they're actually together producing this, co-creating this alternative.
Yeah, so how would you reflect on that?
I think for public authorities, I think it is important to do both these approaches, to both encourage people within the system to change the system, but also to invite people from outside the system and try to learn from that. If we look at the urban greenhouse, I think it is both an adaptation within the system, because it's increased control of production of plants, but also it is outside the system, because it brings food production in the city, whereas before it was on industrial sites or it was in the countryside. And by bringing food production in the city, even though it is high tech, it has already the potential of a much more stronger relation with consumers or with citizens, because it's really in the neighborhood and they can somehow start to relate to this new system. And I think this is one of the challenges that we look forward to, how to engage consumers also in high tech systems that are quite capital intensive. We really, I think, need social innovation to keep the link between concerned consumers, co-creating citizens, and high tech food production.
So that's really interesting, because actually we have seen already a whole portfolio of different ways of approaching it. So it's just let's go and start working on this.
I think the toolbox is really full of approaches, and I think we can bring a lot to the table to feed cities more sustainable, I think.
Okay. Thank you, Jutta and Jan-Willem, for this reflection on the week. And thank you for joining us.